According to Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger, the latest information from the FBI concerning this morning's early shootout went something like this. The two brothers, Jokar and Tamerlan Tsarnaev, robbed a 7-Eleven, then shot an MIT police officer while he was sitting in his car, then carjacked another vehicle and told the driver that they were in fact the Boston Bombers. They were discovered by police. There was that big firefight that we saw from cell phone cameras. And the younger brother, Jokar, got away and the older brother was killed. Congressman Ruppersberger says that the FBI thinks because the two men robbed that 7-Eleven and there were cameras inside, and the fact that they gloated to the driver of that hijacked vehicle that they were the Boston Bombers, that they felt that the gig must have been up. He also said intelligence officials are now trying to piece together a motive which might have something to do with a popular terrorist magazine that is available in the United States.
To set off the type of bombs that they did, there had to be some coordination. So they had to know how to make bombs. Now, Al-Qaeda has a magazine called Inspire that you can get in the United States. And we can't stop that because of First Amendment rights. This magazine, Inspire, basically tells people how to make bombs, especially the type of bombs that were used by the bombers in Boston at the marathon. So whether or not this was a conspiracy, whether other people were involved, were they connected to Chechen rebels, were they connected to an Al-Qaeda, this is what we have to look at on the intelligence community, and that's what we're going to do.